And as a matter of introduction, I just want to mention a quote from Dr. Yamagiwa, which I think relates precisely to the context of the symposium and the new partnership. I believe that conserving nature starts with creating bonds with each other. Gorillas, hunters, and gatherers, and people from various countries, including Japan, should be egalitarian in expanding this bond with each other. Dr. Yamagiwa, please, welcome.
Good morning, everybody. And it's my great pleasure to be here with you. And thank you very much for the one, Patrick, and for welcoming us. And thank you very much for His Excellency, Mr. Kiyoka, joining us this morning. It's my great pleasure. And I would like to introduce, firstly, my university, Kyoto University. And then I will hope something from my field to collaborate with Gold Finishing College.
It's on.
This is on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. And Kyoto University was established in 1897. Just the similar time of Gold Finishing College. And we have 23,000 students, both undergraduate and graduate, and including 2,000 international students at present. And we have 10 faculties, 18 graduate schools, and it's most important things, we have 35 research institute and centers within Japanese Island. And we have 7,000 faculty and staff members, including 400 international staffs. But it's the number of international staff is still very small, so we need to increase in the future. And outside of Japanese Island, we have many overseas branch offices and other offices and facilities. We have 57 overseas offices, especially in Asia and Africa. And we have all over the world 168 MOUs. And we have 114 student exchange programs. Exchange, collaborations with universities overseas. And annually, from abroad, about 2,000 students coming to Kyoto University, and about 3,000 researchers coming to our university. And from our university, about 8,000 researchers going to abroad, and about 2,800 students going to abroad, including Britain. And the mission statement of Kyoto University, academic freedom in self-reliance and self-respect, free thinking and discussion, diverse and interdisciplinary approach, creation of new concepts and research, cutting-edge research, of course, and exploration and field work. And the final aim of our activity to contribute to harmonious coexistence within the human and ecological community on this planet. And we have many laureates who have ever receive international prizes, and needless to introduce. And one thing I would like to strengthen, one of the our spiritual base made by Kinji Imanishi, the late professor of Kyoto University, and he was a famous alpinist, and he said, let's step the Virgin Peak, not only as an alpinist, but as a scientist. So his expedition always included scientific research work and in alpinist activities. And his descendants divided into very wide area of studies, such as human evolution, diversity, universality of culture, and you know, my major, primatology, was one small part of those kind of studies. And when I was a student of Tutu University, I started my career as a primatologist in Africa to study gorillas, my friend's gorillas. And my major is anthropology, and from primatological view. And since I started the present job in Tokyo University, I presented my concept of future Kyoto University, window concept, envisioning the university as a window opening into society and the world at large. That is my concept. And window, that's initial, is I put in both two initiatives, wide and wise. Student must be wise, but also must be wide. International and innovative, natural and noble, diverse and dynamic, original and optimistic, and women leaders in the workplace. That was our goal. So I prefer to provide the opportunity for the student to get the experience of exploration and field work, especially in undergraduate course. And we increase the number of exchanges in international studies. And one of them, one of our trials recently, I would like to provide IRAS seminar. Its aim is to provide first year students with the opportunity to experience cutting edge research. So the firstly I introduced, we have 37 research centers and institutes. So about 1/4 of our faculty staffs are working at those institutes and centers. So they have no obligation to educate undergraduate students. So we request those researchers to have a very short seminar or educational opportunities to foster the first year student to introduce their cutting edge research work. That is very important for the first year student to know what is research activity. And its concept is small classes, 5 to 25 students in the one class, but learning through discussion. Discussion is very important. The number of courses we provided now, we're providing now about 300 courses, including several overseas courses. And another one is Omoro Challenge Program. These days, undergraduate students are not active, are not positive to go. So we're providing them the opportunity and to finance them to go by their own approach. So to foster wisdom and an adventurous spirit in students, as the professor mentioned, and customized by each student, experience-based learning program is the main spirit. And it's a very short period, 3 weeks or more, and destinations anywhere in the world. And Omoro Challenge Program I forgot to explain omoro. Omoro means in Japanese interesting, unique, funny, many meanings. But you know, students by their own to get their own interest in the subject. That is very important. And Omoro Child Program is organized by Kyoto University to provide the chance student to go anywhere. And Hakubi Project is one of the most important programs to employ the cutting-edge young researchers as the staff members in Kyoto University. Employment period is 5 years. And research environment that allows researchers to devote themselves to their studies. They have no educational obligations. 5 years only to concentrate their own studies. We aid them to research in anywhere, not only in Kyoto campus, university's campus, in Nagoya. That's all. And now us, at present in Kyoto University, we have 3 departments to study and educate arts. One is in aesthetic and art history in faculty and graduate school at Reference. And second is in graduate school of advanced integrated studies in human survivability. Maybe I hope Professor now Tosa will explain later about that course. And design school at graduate school reading program. And 3 courses are now ongoing. But, oh yes. In graduate school of integrated and advanced studies in Kyoto University, have the concept of 8 thoughts. In Japanese, hashi. It's composed 8 thoughts, different thoughts. So, in that 8 thoughts, we can find art section, in which Professor Tosa is now leading this project. But we need more. Artistic abilities is very important now, education and research in Kyoto University. So I studied several events in Kyoto University since 2 years ago. And it's called Kyoto University Omoro Talk. Omoro means interesting, unique, and funny. And quest for artistic university. Because we have very few artistic programs inside Kyoto University. And that is 3 to 4 times events in a year. And we invite Omoro artists outside of Kyoto University. The first thing I invited Kyogen Player. Kyogen is a kind of comedy between no, the traditional performance in Kyoto, and the famous performer Senzaburo Shigeyama showed us his original play, and you know, this is Gorilla. He imitated Gorilla performance in his play, in his performance. And I explained why and how he endeavored to imitate Gorilla's behavior from a dramaturgical skill. And we combined another artist like Tosa. She presented her concept of her art, like project mapping. And another time, we invited Yasumasa Morimura. He is famous as his arts as self-portrait.
So you can imagine he performed full, disguised full, Che Guevara, Marilyn Monroe, and Einstein. This is one of them. You can understand who and what he imitated. And another time we invited a Chinese artist, Sai Kokyo. And he was very famous as his art with gunpowder. And his art like this, and the ladder to the heaven. And finally, my work suggests me something on arts, origin of arts. I guess the origin of art was assertion and communication as a function. You know, this is called as display, chest beating. And this is a famous traditional performance in Kabuki in Japan. You know, its meaning very similar. The performance is very different. You know, but you know, performance is very similar. Why? At the beginning of Kabuki was about 300 years ago. But at that time, Japanese people did not know the presence of gorillas. So Japanese people originated this kind of performance, gorillas independent. But why it's similar? You know, bipedal walk is very important for human being, not only as walking, but also as performance, self-assertion. Robot, human being, and gorilla. How you compare? How you understand the difference? Difference is very important for communication. Dancing, as the word in Patrick indicated, is very important for us to communicate as empathy and sympathy we use in our own life. Music is also very important for us, but how and why? That's we must think, we must look back to our evolutionary history. You know, recently, Agency of Cultural Affairs of Japanese government will move to Kyoto within 3 years. So it is very important things, our citizens, Kyoto and Kyoto University. How we organize such as changes recently. Kyoto University opened office in Tokyo last year. And this year, also, Kyoto Academic Forum we opened in just next door of Kyoto, Tokyo office. And this is association of 10 universities which are concerned with artistic education and research and cultural studies and education. So we must associate each other to present not only our traditional arts and culture, but also creative arts and culture in the future, in the window of Tokyo. So lastly, I'd like to present my thought in the future. Our collaboration between science and art is very important for social contribution. You know, science is based always on evidence, and art is based on imagination. Both are very important human characteristics. And we need more technology to adjust such kind of, you know, movement. So we will create in our collaboration the new sense, new concept, and new research work, and such the most contributable our activities to the society. Thank you very much.